All of you from who are doing A level.
Well, we're getting that college, we'll be asking you at 6.
Come and let's go for the exam with you now. You will represent all our brothers who are not here. Come and kneel down your
bless.
Let's clap to the Lord as they come. So early this morning, I partitioned all the rooms of the
room. So
then the second thing you told me, that that's not Kampala building. That's not a building for Kampala Church. The church that will be there, will be the sample church that will only be used to train the workers. Then he told me, I will then give you the Kampala Church. Likely after the end of the year, we will no longer meet
again.
It's an international training center. The second floor, the first floor, is the church. The second floor is a training center. Then in this church hall,
we
are going to have translation equipment that will be translating into 20 languages at the same time. And there will only be one person in front. It costs 20 million. Sorry,
50
million. You will be in your corner. Whatever language you'll be hearing the message in the language. See, they're going to bring people from all over to train you. We have to give them that money.
I'm sorry,
there
will
only be one person
translating.
Nobody will stop the message.
That worry as one back out to you.
That will be for this floor. And the second part of the training center. Then the communication floor. It will not be what you have, the picture you have seen. The view will not stop there. There will be two more floors added before we move it. There will be one of the floors. Just for aggressive strategic praying. At the entrance, and my cry is that we should start with that even before the end of the year retreat. As you are entering, the first room on the left, that control the entrance to the building. And it will be like that for every floor. For all the
subjects,
there will be prayer. And that is not yet the prayer. One of the floor will talk a prayer. I'll give you other details today. But they don't tell me it is finished. And therefore I thank the Lord for it. as a is it right now? No, I want 10 people to stand up and thank the Lord. For the victory that he has given to us. Where we are now. 10 people. One after another. Stand up.
Father Lord, we thank you. We thank you for how far you have brought us concerning this building. We thank you for this step we have reached, O God. It has been you, O God. Thank you for all that you have put in to this stage. In Jesus Christ I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, thank you for the victory you've given us. How far you've carried us, O God, with the building to the finish now. Thank you, Lord. We bless and worship you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Father, great is your faithfulness, O God. We thank you. We thank you for how far you have brought us in the building. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. How far you have brought us in the building, O God. How far you have brought us in this level, Lord. In Jesus' name, I thank you. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord told me that I was giving you a place so that you will settle and train
workers.
So that you will settle without moving around. And people will come from all over.
You
will produce workers. So people will come from all over. From the nation.
Mawanga.
From the region. From different part of the world.
We have
concentrated to produce
workers for our ministry.
We've been quite blessed by the participation of
all the brethren.
Twelve of Sam, who went in a more probable Ganga.
No, probably have been passed.
Tell him to know about the article to Sky now, Chapel.
One of our churches that, to my knowledge, have never given to the work for 15 years. This week from
31,000.
We have been serving 2,000 every Sunday.
I'm
proud of 31,000. And I told him no.
Then
I'm coming. No. That's the breakthrough. As I was praying, and cried out to God, oh God, bless us. Suddenly a message came. One of the sisters from very far sent us 76,000 for the bill. Then one of the days,
as you hold up for a
moment, I was struggling to put money together.
Yeah, together more like a single.
It was 400 shillings. Blessed by the fact that God touched the heart of all his children. This week, what you see outside, they were targeting 2 weeks. It's a work that was supposed to take 2 weeks. It has taken 5 days to complete. May the Lord touch your hearts. So that this week, by next week, these 2 weeks before us, sacrifice all that can be sacrificed. And let the building be where it is ready for the end of the retreat. Then the last week of November, and the whole of December, we will not talk about the building. We'll just talk about the end of the retreat. Be part of the team.
Can we get a good team here?
So that we tell the Lord, you said it. We have done it. I will not ask you to give anything now. When the Lord touches you, stand with us as from today, so that the next 2 weeks, everything is finished. God bless you. This morning I wanted to share on life led on the altar with God. The children can go down. And it was a message on consecration.
That's not the topic.
That's
what we came
on my heart. As the choir they were preparing there, I was on top of the road there. And I felt that we need to tell the brethren. Omuntu yenna
tabananyanga ku byokumu
byokulya
oba mu byokunywa oba olw'embaga oba olw'omwezi oguboneka oba olwa ssabbi.
Are a shadow of the thing that were to come. The reality, however, is found in
Christ.
What is the problem here? That through our salvation, many of us want to have shadows. You want to add shadows.
Baba kongera ke bintu ebirala.
What you eat,
choria,
does not make you more Christian.
Sina makuru roza tuwole mbere mu ofuka mulokole nyo kusinga abalala.
Since it's a doctrinal issue, I want to open your mind to Mark chapter 7.
Roku wacha chitu kwenda
kumunyikiriza. You meet the adventist, you meet the
Muslim, you meet the Abasilamu, banako kuyombeza mwemuli ya mbizi na mwizi ya kena mkuru.
What you eat does not determine where you go.
Ebyo kulya, siyo msalo mwoli mulokole, nyo mani da. Tusekele la baliyami, tubia anja ulo.
Mark chapter 7.
Marko, sule msalo.
From verse 14.
Onyore kumine nya.
Sam.
Mako kumine nya. Mako sule Sam onyore kumine nya.
Again Jesus called the crowd to him and said, listen to me. Listen to me, everyone, and understand this. Nothing outside a man can make him unclean by going into him. Rather, it is what comes out of a man that makes him unclean. After he had left the crowd and entered the house, his disciples asked him about this parable. Are you so dull? He asked. Don't you see that nothing that enters a man from the outside can make him unclean? For it doesn't go into his heart, but into his stomach, and then out of his body. In saying this, Jesus declared all foods clean.
I will tell
you. Naite bibina, nabagamba, mumpulire mwenna, mutegere. Mumpulire mwenna, mutegere. Tewali kintu ekiri ebweru w'omuntu, ekiyingira mu ye, ekiyinza okumwonoona. Naye ebintu ebiva mu muntu byebyo ebyonoona omuntu. Buli alina amatu ag'okuwulira awulire. Awo bwe yayingira mu nnyumba ng'avudde mu bibiina, abayigirizwa be ne bamubuuza olugero olwo. N'abagamba nti, bwe mutyo nammwe temulina magezi, temutegeeranga kyonna ekiri wabwerubwe kiyingira mu muntu, tekiyinza kumwonoona. Kubanga tekiyingira mutima gwe naye mu lubuto lwe nekiyita nekigenda mu kiyiko.
Food does not bring purity.
Emmere tekuvuula mulongo kukusinga balala batagirya.
And there is no food that makes a man impure.
Era tewali mmere ekuvuula mukyafu kusinga balala.
The environment of a man does not make him impure.
Omuntu embeera gy'abeeramu emuli ebweru oba ennyumba gy'asulamu oba ekikyona kyabeeramu tekimufuula mulokokusinga
abalala.
Ekireeta obukyafu kyekyo kiri mutima ekikwonoona so si ebiri mu wabweru.
Impurity is the heart.
Kiva mu mutima gwo ne bw'oba oli muyonyi otelemu omutima mukyafu bwe bukyafu obwo bw'omuntu.
So Jesus told the people.
Yes, you're right, Baba.
And the disciples were surprised.
They never used to match the gear. They were
only. Are you so dull?
Now, Baba, you mean I'm a gear? See,
you mean you are like them?
Now, Baba, you are Baba. You are the gear.
Don't you see that when you eat,
you put it up and you are married.
It goes through the mouth.
You get a mouth to
the throat.
You get a mouth cori.
Through the stomach.
Mouth to
and outside it's gone.
Now, look at the stomach.
But he said there is something else that goes into the heart. What defiles a man's relationship with God is what goes into your heart. Are we together? I wanted to touch this topic because you will meet the Adventists. And you even meet some believers. And since some people here, they love their work, they will defend the doctrine of God. It's not a doctrine. Are we together?
But
this was a side issue. Your long skirt does not make you
a believer.
You can wear very long. The wearing of a trouser or not wearing of a trouser does not make a person a believer or not a believer. If you go to India, most Indians have trousers. But culturally, in the setting in which we are, most people will link a woman who wears trousers with something else. In India, when they dress, from here up, it is open. The Indian morality is tied to the legs. Professor was telling us something. He went to India. A brother told him, if a woman is moving, and he's having something and he falls, his horse falls, don't go to pick it for her.
ogeza
kutunulira mumagulu ge bantu mbweze kati
abayindiantu
mwezi
omukyalaoyo
aba
mwensilwaki
boye bajjawa obalaba olubuto tebalubikka boye bizinfuno byago tebibakwasa nsonyi basobola okwambala ebyona wansi naye wanebatega kakaya katono bwe kati naye ebyomulokole
where you go
gyolaga yonna
and you find out
n'ozuula
that the morality of the people is tight here
obuwanga bw'abantu abo bobeye bikkanyo waggulu oba nviiri
and you don't cover it
we don't azibikka
you will cause people to stumble
obojokeza abantu okwesittala
you are not dressing for yourself
obulokole jjukira enyambalayo si toyambalirako wabula oyambala kuyamba abantu abakwetolodde bajo eri yesuwo kati bw'oyambala omubi oyinza okwesittaza abantu
abo naye
bw'obanga gweolekwako wekka
ebyo
ebyambala byeyagala byambalire mu kisenge kyo bweba obeera wekka mu
kisengeoli
mukisengekyokyosula
ogenda
mukinaabiro nomala okunaabaokulumanga bw'oyagala
mukubanga
oli wekka mu kisenge ekyo bino bikubonyaabonya ebigoye engoye zitumalako
mirembegemazima
engoye mugugu gwe twetikka
olokwesiba
newetereza wena wena newekolako naye bw'obeera wekka mu kisenge osula bwomu nga bw'oyagala naye
ofuluma
bwoti toyinza kufuluma bukunya abantu bajja kwetala
kale
tewayambalira kulula wekka oyambala kuyamba balala kati woba
oyambalaweebuuze if others see me
byenyambadde bato banandaba
what will happen to their hearts
banalowooza ki mu mitima
that's all
kyekyokka
if not
kitabo ekyo
listen brethren
ulize olugaa
in those days
ebiseera ebyedda
people move naked
abantu batambulanga bwere nga tebalina goye balimanazisuula
ani
afaayo obaoliweereeyo obaowesimeko kawero
ebiseera
ebyo ngaobugoba tebunaba kukyankalana nga we buli kati
webatandika
okwebikka ebitundu
ebyekyamaomugo
abantu balinga okwagala balaba ate ebyo
from the moment don't eat this food that's what man want to eat
omuntu bwali bwatyo ebisale bwemugala tokikola tenekyakola kati waliwo bagamba toyambala kyo kyebagala okwambalira ddala
what is covered
kiki kyobikka
is what people will want to see kyobikka
abantu kyebagala
tokwebuza
lwaki okibikka empisa
yekati
abantu ekitundu ekimu obaobwaoba egwanga oba kabira yonna basalao etujja kwebikanga bwetu ate gwe nojja newebikkula oba esitaza
we don't dress for ourselves we dress for the sake of others and therefore culturally we ask which dress will destroy the people here
engoye zetwambala tezirambala ku lwaffe wabula tuzambala ku lwabala n'olwekyo bw'oba oyambala weebuuze bwenayambala bwe nti abantu bano kinaabayisa batya mu mitima gyabwe kinaabeesittaza oba nedda
also get it. Therefore, if one day you see her in US with trousers, then you write on the Facebook, Patricia has become a terrible backslider. Meanwhile, she's dressing for the sake of a winter. You miss it. But if she comes here, in hot sun,
and
go to put dust in,
I will say
you are putting it in my heart. Back to Colossians. So Paul said,
Paulo Magamba,
religious festivals, dressing,
nenyamba,
eating,
new
moon,
Christmas,
these are shadows. We don't run after shadows. The reality is of Christ. If after this meeting, you see us walking on our building outside,
these people went and started. Pastor, I'm going to stand there.
On Sunday, I work more than all other days. So Sunday is not a Sabbath for me. It's not a Sabbath for me. A Sabbath was a day to rest. If Sunday is meant for me to rest, that's a terrible day for resting.
Sabbath
was the seventh day after God had finished his work. He rested on the Sabbath. After he had finished doing his work, he rested and he established a day of rest. And get it. A day of rest after you have finished your work.
Monday,
resting. Tuesday, resting. Friday, resting. Then Saturday, I cannot work. Then the early church decided to have a day. A day of worship. And they put it called Sunday. The day that the Lord Jesus resurrected. That was the day they met together to worship the resurrected Jesus. The Sabbath of Judaism was a Saturday, and it came along together with the law of Moses. That's the day they blocked. But the Christian decided to choose the day the Lord Jesus resurrected. And when you read church history, they were persecuted by the Jews. The fact that they don't keep their Sabbath. Go and read people like Josephus.
So
they say, is there any other thing that we have been persecuted in more than the fact that we don't keep their Sabbath?
So they early believer
did not keep their Sabbath. Those who are keeping a Sabbath today called Saturday, they come from Moses and not from Christ. If I dwell on that, I will miss it. Let's go.
Verse 7.
Since the shadow of things that were to come, the reality, however, is found in Christ.
Verse 18.
Do not let anyone disqualify you in false humility and the worship of. Do not let anyone who delight in false humility and the worship of angels disqualify you for the prize.
Omuntu yenna takunyagangako empeera yammwe mu kwewombeeka okwayagala yekka n'okusinzanga bamalayika.
Bulungi.
Abalina okwewombeeka okwekifere.
You can be sanctimonious,
you can
be sanctified. This is how, when they are coming to church,
They move like this when they are approaching church. In
ritual,
so all their holiness
that means sanctimonious.
Without
inner sanctimonious. That's what
they
call false humility.
Somebody's
coming
to pray.
The changing of your voice. Listen,
brethren.
Most black change their voice to resemble American. The voice of God is like the voice of
America. Baba limba ndi woyogera zvinhu zvechimerica mololi
mutokuvho. That God
Christ
Jesus was a white.
Mukatonda Yesu yali muzungu baba limba limba.
Mine. What is that? That was for fortune. I have one brother in the West. To me, I know that the only time he has come to Kampala have been moment we have invited him for
MBA.
When he's talking
with
he said he was I'm going to see.
Omuntu ali mu kyaleeri alimu emimonde era akakogera nga mu America.
That's what you call false humility.
We bayita okukotekako obuwombefu bw'ekifulere. Okwefuula mbumbu ojjamu kusaba n'okyuse entunulayo n'endabikayo n'enjogere balowooza nti oli mutukuvu. Kitange.
Put delight in false humility.
from you.
You should worship the Lord in the language.
The court is about a group of people who are
sick.
Ziragenti bebasumba wabera bishop.
Without asking who was the first person who made it, so that it will link you with one American.
Bagala balabikenga oli okusoma mu Meriko oli.
Have you realized? That almost everything is being abandoned that which truly belongs to us. I won her a number of times. Unfortunately, she didn't take my
warning.
I said, the day you stop being the Elizabeth that you are.
And
when Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
I will get a
message.
That is the
insight.
So that.
You want. Let me be careful. Let me control it out. Can I get the same? Can I get this job or get a new magnetic? You want to go for it?
Even just looking at all our children, I can tell you what characterizes each of them.
So, what would you do? And Balay, the Chikula Chimunda.
Some of you did not know what happened to
Lydia.
Lydia was behind here.
Lydia was behind here.
So dumb. I even thought she was sleeping. She was sleeping, I was not understanding. She was pointing that side. I thought she wanted to go there. I said yes.
And
then she came forward here. She came back to life. Lydia wanted to show her a new dress. She enjoyed herself when she came to the corner there.
We have to mass. Now that we talk,
there are some people, if you imprison them behind you, they will die. But there are some people, you push them forward, they will die. I studied the choir. There's a lot of battle we should be in front. Some push them forward. So that it's as if some of them are playing their tactics. They don't even look at my
display.
When I'm saying,
no, my God, they are back to back to anybody. We're going to have a balance today.
I'm getting
which thing?
Listen, brother.
Who's all the guys?
There are some people
who want to have a
move. We enjoy them.
Oh, my, you know, we have a mass.
And I can tell you,
so
where such people will function best. Those are the evangelists. They are those who want to be here. And after
a time,
wait,
don't you say? You must go now. She will not fool.
This is what the closet is all about.
They
want to be hidden in the presence of
God.
If you study them well, even if they have to be singers, they should back from behind. For some don't know where they should
be.
They should be helped. Their only problem is when they are acting like this, they should be trained.
When they are missing
the
spot,
who delight in vision. You are not a greater Christian because of the vision you see.
That's
what Paul was talking about. So that you start looking down
on the vision.
Such a person go into great detail about what he has seen. And his spiritual mind
puffs
him up. His own spiritual mind puffs him up. They forget the fact that after Obama, they will turn that to the Trump, the Antichrist. One generation come and go, and their children has failed them, and they will not change. It is on spiritual mind,
making them so important.
Get it, brethren. The exercising of one spiritual gift does not make you more important than another.
Your
spiritual gift does not make you more important. You are great because of your character, not your
gifts.
Verse 19 says he has lost connection with the head. Whom the whole body is supported and held by its ligament and sinew grows as God causes it to grow. All that we have said is that we are full. We are nothing to our salvation. Have you understood? Clap to the Lord because
we have come to God.
That's the rounding up of what we were handling last. Verse 20. Since you die with Christ to the basic principle of this world. Why, as though you still belong to it, do you submit to its rule? Do not touch, do not test, do not handle.
Chichi, echimete sawansi wa mateka nga agati nga bachalabala mu nsi titokwa atangako toregangako sutokomangako.
We died with Christ.
Twafana Kristo.
Verse
23.
Such regulation have indeed an appearance of wisdom.
Enonezo zidamikangezi echifananye chamagezi.
With their self-imposed worship.
They
are false humility.
And their
harsh treatment of the body. But they lack any value to restraining sensual indulgence. It doesn't matter how you treat your body. You cannot.
Your body and it helps you for healing.
And a number of people always understand fasting. Fasting is not a mistreatment of your body. It is a separation from something separated to God. You cannot mistreat your body and it help you to stop sin. The issue about sin is a matter of the heart. Yes.
In Roman Catholicism,
sometimes you are given part of the punishment. You have punished yourself. You have beat yourself.
You have beat
yourself. As we fast,
I want
you to know that that's the greatest moment. It's not a mistreatment of yourself. It is the keeping of yourself, keeping of your spirit. I want to challenge everybody
at the
end of this part of
the
part. I want us in Uganda to give God
1,500
people who are fasting.
Njagala mu Uganda kanga tumwe abantu 15 basimi.
At least
watch
here in Kampala.
Kampala,
make sure you contribute.
Akasat now, why would you want?
God will do many things.
Praise
the Lord.
Come on, yes.
Let's approach
through chapter 3.
I will introduce it and you want to read it. You want to study it. Verse 1. Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your heart on things above where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
Kalabanga mwanzu kira wamune Christo, muno nyende mini wakuru Christo jari na tunde kumkono wadio kwa katonda.
Hallelujah. We are not talking about the new life.
Katonga kulamo vupia.
Set your heart on things above.
Kwa kwa kute kubitwe mini mkuru wakuru.
Set your heart on things
above.
One of the first principles in expressing the new life you have, set your heart on things above. Get focused on Christ and get focused on what God has called you for. The Christian life is like a marathon race. As anybody who win the race, you get focused on the finishing line. If you will win the race, you get focused on the finishing line. So the expression of the new life in us demand that we focus our mind on certain things, focus our heart on certain things, and take away our heart from certain things.
Check out this or one of them. Every time I have been to take a movie to a really massive affair, we go to be jet to be jet to be living one.
Paul is saying,
Paul,
because you have died. Because you have separated yourself from
sin.
Because you are no longer
sinner.
Because you now belong to Christ.
There are
things you should do. You have a partner to contribute. And the partner is one.
So
know that you now belong to someone. You are new. You are new. You are running a race. You must set out to finish the race. Be focused. Be focused. Take your eyes from the things around.
Take
Focus on the thing that belongs to God. Focus on the calling of God. Focus on your relationship with God. Focus on that day. What will happen when you finally meet God? Then focus. The expression of the new life
means
you should get focused.
Paul
said, since we are surrounded by such a great
cloud of witnesses,
let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us.
Tuduke mpaka zino zetuli mu ngatulemera ko.
Looking unto Jesus.
Tunulinde Yesu.
Looking unto Jesus.
Tunulinde Yesu.
The author and finisher of our faith.
Omutambisi era omumaliriza okukkiriza.
He said because of the joy that was set before him.
Olwesanyu limutekiri limusubiddwa
mu maaso. Because of the joy was set before him. He endured the cross. He despised the shame. He endured the cross. He endured the cross because of the joy set before him. He was looking forward to something.
That
with difficult moment he had to go through. And there will be difficult moment
to go through.
We will be insulted. We
don't
concentrate on the insult of
him.
We will be hardship. We are not distracted by God's petition. We get focused. We get focused on the finishing line. He has called me heavenward. He has called me heavenward. And then fuck us on what he has called me to be and to do. Get focused on the finishing line. Set your mind on things above, not on earthly things. You want to get focused on earthly things. The multitude of other things around. You want to get focused on this. Focus on this. You cannot go far with God unless you set out to be focused on
God.
There are many other things. Are you so caught up with how great you want to become? You want to become the richest in the world.
And setting that
God you want to become the richest in the world.
For
what purpose?
To
make a name in the world. Then you have set your heart on things below, not on things above. Are you focused your heart to know God? As Paul said, I want to know him. I want to know him.
Are you focused on him?
I want to become like him. I want to fellowship with him. I want to hear his voice. I want to be changed into his likeness. I want to know how God was. Who is he? Who is
he?
How does it look like in character? I want to become like him in character. I want to become like him in humility. I want to become like him in purity. I want to become like him in truth. I want to become like him in kindness. You are focusing on things above.
You are focusing on things above.
Verse 3 says, for you died. And now your life is now hidden with Christ
in
God.
He
said you died. When Christ, who is your life, appeared, then will you also appear with him in glory.
Listen, brethren.
He said we are not looking for glory now for
ourselves.
Because we died. We are not looking for ourselves glory. We died. Our glory is tomorrow. When Christ appears, we will appear with him. We will appear with him in glory. If
you are looking for reward now, you waste it. If you are looking for congratulations now, you waste it. We died. We died. Verse 5.
Kale mufiise ebitundu byammwe ebiri ku nsi. Kitegeeza.
Because you are on a race.
Olw'okuba oli mu
mpaka. Clothing you can no longer wear.
Waliwo engoye zotalina kwambala nate.
Put to death.
Ti. Okitegeeza, olina okutta.
Strip yourself.
Ebintu ebimu olina
okubyeggyako. It did not say that God will take them away from you. Another version said, rid yourself.
What belongs
to your earthly nature? There are certain things that belong to your earthly nature. One, sexual immorality. He said, all that I have to do with sexual immorality belongs to your earthly nature.
Yes,
all that makes you impure. All that makes you lustful. Little brethren, you can never watch a pornographic film and remain the same. Practical holiness means whatever belongs to your earthly nature, it will slow you down in the race. Whatever will slow you down. After listening to that ungodly music, it will slow you down in the rest. After watching that ungodly film, it will slow you down. It is saying that there are certain things you carry, it will wear you down. It is saying that there are some relationships in your life that will wear you down, that will slow you down. You want to run the race, but in time you need the best. You slow down.
So
there was a time that Jesus healed a man. And told him, don't go back to the village. There are some places you don't qualify to go there now. They will slow you down in the race. But there will be a time if you go, you will not be hindered. You have grown. He said, take off. Take off. This used to be your life. Verse 8. You must rid yourself of all such things as this anger. Have you confronted yourself that the fact that sometimes the anger possesses you?
What was that? Your rules of soul could you like no?
And you are waiting for the day that God will deliver you. You are lying. It will not happen. You rip it. You pull it out of your life. You pull it out of your life.
osibiddwa obwejjudde obusungu
ekiruyi
obusungu naye
ddala
ekiruyi kikujjudde
amaaso
gonna gatwakala bwoti obusungu bukujjudde kibaite ekiruyi
owambiddwa obusungunebukula
ne bugenda ku ddaala eryekiruyi mu bufalansa
Rabies is a disease, an animal.
You see the husband coming back.
Then finally you calm down. And when you calm down, you pray.
No such a
call. Then you realize you are yourself. There is a demon operating in you. Nobody can cast away that demon. So the Bible says, read it. If you are not lifting up others with your words, your language is filthy. If you are not encouraging others when you speak, your language is filthy. If somebody listens to you and before prayer does not start worshiping God, your language is filthy. Do not lie to each other. Since you have taken up, you have to all say what you practice. And
have
put on the new self. So get it, brethren. The old life is taken off. The new life is put on. Get it, brethren. The old life is taken off. And the new life put on. And it is not done by God. That is what God does. That is what
we
do.
But
you do not come and take
their
phone and delete all those immoral pictures.
He
will not do it. He has committed himself that
you
will never trespass your free will. God will not come and open your
heart
and destroy those pictures that continue to remind you about that girl. So that each time you look, I say, believe, I talk about my ex. I know I'm dealing with a person who does not regret the past. When I used to be my ex. Do you think about that person? Oh, who is? If you sit, listen. So when you find a phone call is coming,
it's for my ex.
Hello. Does it not take
you that you are
still in Egypt? And that you are regretting this kukumba. You are regretting about this manna we are giving you. You are deciding the kukumba. Why are you regretting the fact that you are a believer? Why are you missing the nightclubs?
Why missing
the flies were always
telling us. Patricia. No, that book went to something.
Men no longer come.
I can't.
I shaved my head again.
ebirevu ebyao abaana bona nga bajja nenda bakatoka bwetuka bwe tebajja bwegira bwetu ne basembera inanza ebiseera ebyo obulokole buno bana
By telling you, you are missing it.
What are we missing? What is it that we are missing present? The immorality? The eggs?
Amaji, or Sidim.
The gonorrhea? The syphilis?
Kabotongo.
Is that what we're missing?
It will be your Suwamosi.
Broken hearts?
Is that what
we're missing?
It will be your Suwa.
The fact that nobody can trust you again?
What you
is that what we're missing?
You are going to be a man.
The fact that when you are near somebody, the person holds his phone very well. Is that what we
are
missing?
The
fact that we are having sleepless nights. Broken relationships. Use and throw.
Is that
what we are missing? Why don't we tell ourselves? At last. We have found it and we
enter
into our rest. We have found what the world has been looking for and we will not let it go. How many people do you want to break your heart before you come to
us?
Why don't you tell
us?
Thank you.
Come on.
After all the mess,
and
I have an opportunity to live a life and be true to you.
And
be at peace. Enjoy your peace. Thank you. What the world is looking for, I have found. Let's pray.
Lord, we thank you so much, O God, for rescuing that soul, God, for the dominion of darkness. We thank you for rescuing that soul, God, the ways of the world, O God, and our translation as we appeal to your blessing. For we pray that we shall keep our focus, O God, unto Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For we pray none of us shall shrink back to be destroyed. Oh, for we pray
yet our eyes be open to the fact of where we are, oh God. It's a safer place. It's a better place, oh God. We pray that all deception of the world in our hearts will be crushed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That all the zeals of the world will be crushed, will crumble in our hearts. How shall I desire? How shall I keep our focus to you, God? In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, I pray that we shall fix our eyes, oh God, to you. So we can finish this marathon, we can finish this race that we have started, oh God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lord, we thank you. We bless you, oh God. Thank you for your word, O King of glory. Lord, I pray that you help us to be sensitive, oh God, to enjoy the life full in Christ, oh Lord. The life in Christ, O King of glory. Lord, I pray that we'll take a step, oh God, to disobey the kingdom of darkness, oh God, and obey the kingdom of God, O King of glory. I pray, oh God, that we'll be sensitive, oh God. Oh, I pray that we'll put to death, oh God, all that belongs to the world, oh God. We'll put to death all the worldly attires, oh God, all that belongs to the world. Lord, we'll put to death, O King of glory. And I pray that we'll set our mind, O God, on things above. Things, O King of glory, that make us, O God, to be in line with the word of God. We'll set our mind, O God, on things on heaven, O King of glory. And I pray for each one of us, O God, that no one will hesitate, O King of glory. Lord, I pray that we'll not regret, O God, we'll not regret of salvation, O God. I pray, O God, that we'll not regret, O God, of the great salvation, God. The great rescue that you've given unto us will not regret, O King of glory, of the things that we were doing in the past. Will not regret of our past, O God, but each of us will set our mind, our best in Christ Jesus, O God, as we do the work, O God. My Father, I pray, O God, that each of us will take a step, O God, will take an action, O God, will be moved by the Spirit of God, will not hold back, O God, will not sit down, O King of glory, but will take a step to break, O God, all that may make us not to enjoy the life and life in abundance with Christ. I pray that you help us, that we'll understand this word, we'll understand this great mystery, O God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you very much for your word, O Lord. Father, we pray in your name that we shall focus on you, that we shall focus on our relationship with you, O Lord, and that we shall build it, O Lord, so that we become more and more like you, O Lord. Father, we pray in your name, O Lord, that we shall rid ourselves of all things that entangle us, O Lord, that cause us not to focus on you, O Lord. And Lord, we pray that we shall rid ourselves of all sinful things in our lives, O Lord. Father, we pray that we shall rid ourselves of anger, O Lord, of rage, of malice, of slander, O Lord. We pray in the name that we shall rid ourselves of these things in our lives, of that not belong to you. And we shall become more and more like you. We shall put on the new self, O Lord. And we shall put on the new self and grow in the new self and put off the old self and put off all the expectations of this world, O Lord. Father, we pray, O Lord, that we shall be transformed, O Lord, to become more and more like you, O Lord. We pray that you do it for each one of us, O Lord, that we shall focus on you. Focus on the things above, O Lord. Focus on the things that build your kingdom, O Lord. We pray that you do it for us. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
May the Lord help each of us to truly put on that new self.
May we
cooperate with God so that we reach and become what He wants us to be.
The men started evangelizing Kapoja and won people to the Lord. We cannot let those people hanging.
So
we can sit down,
please.
We are challenging the men to go back there. We are asking a good number of you youth come and join even this team. This evening. We are going to have a meeting there. So that we can get back those
so
who will lead to the Lord. So we ask a good number of you to join us this evening in Kaboja for the meeting there. And the men, please do everything to be there. Follow up until you have handed over your convert and you start meeting in that house,
church.
In the church there. So by 4:30, they would have set the machine there. So a number of people, please, cooperate. Who can be available to God? Put up your hand rapidly. One more people, please. One more people. The young people should come. All the youth. Nicholas. I want all the youth. All the youth. And your house church will release you. So that we lay hold on something there. So those men plus those youth, please. Brian, can you drop the people there by four? Please, Brian will drop those who are waiting
for
the machine. God bless you.